Have you ever wondered what turns a simple mix of cream and sugar into the smooth, irresistible treat we all scream for? Ice cream. Picture this. A sweltering summer day, the sun beating down, and the one thing on your mind is the refreshing, velvety chill of ice cream. It's a universal craving, and for good reason. Did you know that the global ice cream market is valued at over $70 billion, with millions of scoops enjoyed daily across the globe? But what makes ice cream so magical? Is it the creamy texture, the delicate balance of flavors, or the science that freezes it just right? In this video, we're diving into the frosty world of frozen desserts, starting with the classic ice cream, before uncovering the secrets behind sorbet and gelato. From mixing and whipping to freezing and flavoring, you'll learn how these delightful treats go from ingredients to indulgence. Let's begin with the most iconic of them all, how ice cream is made.
Before we dive deeper into the fascinating stories behind how these everyday ice creams are made, I'd love to ask for your support. Our goal is to reach 300 subscribers by the end of the year, and your help can make a huge difference. If you're enjoying this journey into the secrets of sugar, salt, and pepper, please hit that subscribe button. It's quick, free, and it means the world to us.
Thank you so much for being here, and now let's get back to uncovering the amazing process behind these smoothie essentials. Ice cream, just saying the word, brings a smile to most faces. But what makes it so special? It's not just the ingredients. It's the entire process that turns a simple blend into the creamy, dreamy dessert we all love. Imagine walking into your favorite ice cream shop, opening the freezer, or hearing that familiar jingle of the ice cream truck. Behind every scoop is a fascinating journey that blends science, art, and a little bit of magic. Here's the thing, ice cream starts with the basics. Milk, cream, sugar, and sometimes eggs. These ingredients are whisked together to form a base. Sounds simple, right? But this is where the real magic begins. Did you know that the texture of your favorite ice cream depends heavily on the balance of these ingredients? Too much sugar and it's too soft. Too much cream and it's overly heavy. It's all about striking the perfect harmony. But it doesn't stop there. Once the base is ready, it's time to add flavor. From classic vanilla to adventurous mixes like salted caramel or mint chocolate chip, the possibilities are endless. This is where creativity comes into play. Think about your favorite flavor. Chances are, someone experimented with dozens of ingredients to make it just right. Now here's a cool fact. The churning process is what gives ice cream its smooth, creamy texture. As the mixture freezes, it's constantly stirred to prevent ice crystals from forming. Without churning, you'd end up with something more like a frozen block than the silky scoop you crave. And let's not forget about air. Yes, air is an important part of ice cream. It's whipped in during churning to make it light and fluffy. Without it, ice cream would feel dense and heavy. Finally, the mixture is frozen at just the right temperature. Cold enough to solidify, but not so cold that it loses that soft, scoopable consistency. This delicate balance is why ice cream feels so luxurious in every bite. Whether you're enjoying it in a cone, a bowl, or sandwiched between two cookies, ice cream has a universal charm. It's comfort food, a celebration treat, and for many, a nostalgic bite of happiness. But not all frozen desserts are alike. So how does a light, refreshing sorbet differ from the creamy richness of ice cream? Let's take a closer look at how sorbet is made. Picture this, a hot summer day, the sun blazing, and you take a spoonful of sorbet. Instantly, it melts on your tongue, refreshing you like a splash of cold water. Sorbet isn't just a dessert, it's a sweet escape from the heat. But have you ever wondered how it achieves that smooth, icy texture without the creaminess of ice cream? Unlike its creamy cousin, sorbet is all about simplicity. It starts with just two key ingredients, fruit and sugar. That's right, no milk, no cream, no eggs. Sorbet is the lighter, dairy-free alternative that lets the natural flavors of the fruit shine. Think of it as summer in a bowl. Whether it's the vibrant tang of mango, the zing of lemon, or the deep sweetness of raspberry. Now here's the fun part. The fruit isn't just blended, it's carefully pureed to create a smooth, even base. If the fruit is too chunky, the sorbet won't have that velvety texture we all love. And the sugar? It does more than just sweeten. It's actually what keeps the sorbet soft enough to scoop. Too little sugar and it freezes too hard. Too much sugar and it won't freeze properly. The balance has to be just right. Once the fruit and sugar are combined, the mixture is chilled and churned. You might be wondering, why churn something without cream? The answer lies in the science of freezing. Churning adds air and keeps ice crystals small, creating that smooth, scoopable texture. Without it, sorbet would be more like a block of flavored ice. And here's a little secret. Sorbet often includes a splash of something extra, like lemon juice or even a pinch of salt, to enhance the flavors. That's why sorbet tastes so bright and refreshing. It's all about letting the fruit take center stage. But sorbet isn't just a dessert, it's also a palate cleanser, often served between courses in fancy meals. Why? Because its light, clean flavors help reset your taste buds. It's a dessert with a purpose. So next time you savor a spoonful of sorbet, think about how this simple combination of fruit, sugar, and technique creates something so elegant. But if sorbet is all about being light and refreshing, how does gelato, a dessert known for its rich, dense texture, stand out? Let's explore how gelato is made. Now that we've learned about ice cream and sorbet, let's dive into the world of gelato, a treat that shares some similarities with ice cream, but has its own special twist. Gelato, the Italian favorite, is known for its rich flavor and smooth, dense texture. But how is gelato made? And what makes it different from the ice cream we all know and love? Gelato starts with a simple base made from milk, cream, sugar, and sometimes eggs. But the main difference between gelato and ice cream comes in how these ingredients are combined. In gelato, less cream is used and there's more milk compared to ice cream, which helps give gelato its lighter, smoother texture. This balance of ingredients also means that gelato has a lower fat content than ice cream, which allows its flavors to shine through much more brightly. The process of making gelato is a bit slower than ice cream, and that's part of the reason why gelato is so dense and creamy. The mixture is churned at a slower speed, which introduces less air, a process known as overrun. While ice cream can have as much as 50% air mixed into it, gelato only has about 25%. This lack of air gives gelato its rich and velvety texture that's much smoother than ice cream. Another key difference is temperature. Gelato is served at a slightly warmer temperature than ice cream, around 10 to 15 degrees Fahrenheit higher. This helps make the gelato even smoother and more flavorful. When you take a bite, the flavors seem to burst in your mouth because they're not as cold, allowing your taste buds to experience them in a deeper way. Flavors of gelato range from simple vanilla and chocolate to more adventurous choices like pistachio, tiramisu, and hazelnut. The key to gelato's incredible flavor is that the ingredients used are often fresher and more natural than those used in other frozen treats. Many gelato makers use fresh, seasonal fruits and nuts, which gives their gelato a pure, clean taste. Making gelato is an art, and each batch is carefully crafted to balance the ingredients perfectly. Whether it's a traditional Italian recipe or a modern twist on classic flavors, gelato is a labor of love. It's all about getting the right mix of milk, sugar, and flavors to create something truly special that's loved by so many. So now you can appreciate all the hard work that goes into making each scoop of gelato with its creamy texture and unforgettable taste. Next time you enjoy a cup of gelato, you'll know exactly what makes it different from ice cream and why it's such a delicious treat. So after all that, what's your favorite frozen treat? Are you more of a creamy ice cream lover? a fruity sorbet fan, or do you prefer the rich, velvety goodness of gelato? Each one has its own unique charm, and now you know just how they're all